हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू गेट एकेडमी ग्लोबल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पांस ऑफ फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर। ओके, प्लीज नोट डाउन द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर। बाय डिफॉल्ट नेगेटिव फीडबैक सिस्टम, दिस इज द बेसिक एम्पलीफायर, दैट मीन्स द ए, द फीडबैक पाथ गेन इज द बीटा। ओके, the V naught, and this one is the Vs. First, note down frequency response. Frequency response of this basic amplifier. This is the frequency response of basic amplifier. The A naught. The A naught by root 2. This one is the FL, this is the FH, okay, this is the F. This represents the frequency response of basic amplifier. A naught is the mid-band gain. This A naught is the mid-band gain. This is the important terminology in frequency response, or maximum gain of amplifier. Maximum gain of A, maximum gain, okay, maximum gain of A. This FL is referred as, this FL is referred as lower 3 dB frequency, the lower 3 dB frequency or cutoff frequency, the lower 3 dB frequency of high pass filter. This is the cutoff frequency for high pass filter. FH is the higher 3 dB frequency, is the higher 3 dB frequency of low pass filter. That means this FH is the cutoff frequency for low pass filter, this FL is the cutoff frequency for high pass filter, and the difference between this, the FH minus FL, is referred as bandwidth. The bandwidth of basic amplifier, that means bandwidth of basic amplifier, is given by FH minus FL, the cutoff frequency of two filters, low pass filter as well as high pass filter. This A naught is the mid band gain. Why this frequency is referred as 3 dB frequency? Because this is the 3 dB down, this is the 3 dB down. The definition of any 3 dB frequency, definition of any 3 dB frequency, the frequency at which gain will be 70.7% or 1 by root 2 times of its midband value. The frequency at which gain will be 70.7% or 1 by root 2 times. 1 by root 2 times, that means 0.707, that means the 70.7% of its midband value is referred as 3 dB frequency. Why this 3 dB frequency? Because in case of dB representation, we represented any quantity x is a 20 log x. In dB representation, we represented any quantity x is given by 20 log x. Normally, this x can be written as in terms of voltage gain, in terms of current gain. If I am considering 1 by root 2 in terms of dB, that means that 20 log 1 by root 2. 20 log 1 by root 2, that means the minus 3.010, that means the minus 3 dB. That's why we used this term 3 dB frequency, because in this frequency gain will be 1 by root 2 times or 70.7% of its midband value, and this 1 by root 2 times, this 1 by root 2 in terms of dB is given by minus 3 dB. That's why we used 3 dB frequency terminology. Okay, first I will cover basic frequency response of low pass filter. First, I will cover basic frequency response of low pass filter. Frequency response of low pass filter is given by A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH. The frequency response of low pass filter is given by A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH, where A naught is the midband gain. This A, magnitude of A, is given by A naught upon under root 1 plus F upon FH whole square. This one. The value of A at F equal to 0 is written by A naught. The value of A at F equal to FH, at F equal to FH, that means this result is A naught by root 2. The value of this A at F equal to infinite, this result is 0. That means the frequency response of low pass filter is given by, this is the A, frequency response of low pass filter, this is the A naught on this one, this. This is the frequency response of low pass filter. This is the A0 and this is the FH. This is the FH. The A0 by root 2. This FH is referred as 3 dB frequency. This FH is referred as 3 dB frequency of low pass filter. If I am considering ideal characteristics for the low pass filter, that means this is the pass band, this is the FH. FH, that means the cutoff frequency. This is the pass band, the pass band, the mid band gain A naught, or this is the stop band, stop band. The ideal characteristics. Mathematically, this is the given by A equal to A naught when F is less than equal to FH and 0 when F greater than FH. This is the ideal characteristic. After cutoff frequency, resultant will be 0. That means low pass, in case of low pass filter, this low pass filter passes the low frequency signal. That means this low pass filter provides the maximum gain for the low frequency, and the mid band gain, this low pass filter provides the mid band gain at the 0 frequency, because the lowest frequency is 0. That means the DC frequency, low pass filter provides the maximum gain at DC frequency, that means the 0 frequency, and in low frequency range, this filter provides the maximum gain. And this frequency response decreases with the frequency. This FH is referred as 3 dB frequency or cutoff frequency. This is the basic characteristics of low pass filter. Okay. After that, this cutoff frequency, this magnitude will decrease towards 0. Okay. In case of high pass filter, if I am considering high pass filter. Frequency response of high pass filter is given by A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F. This frequency response is very, very important for representation. A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F. Here, in case of low pass filter, this frequency response is given by A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH. And in high pass filter, this A is given by A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F. In case of magnitude, A naught upon under root 1 plus FL upon F whole square. That means magnitude of A at F equal to 0, that result will be F is equal to 0, 1 by 0, that means the infinite, infinite square, that means the infinite, 1 plus infinite, that means the infinite, under root of infinite, that means infinite, A naught by infinite 0. The magnitude at F equal to FL, this magnitude at F equal to FL, this resultant will be A naught by root 2. And this magnitude at F is equal to infinite, that means 1 by infinite, that means the 0, 1 plus 0, that means the 1, that means resultant will be A naught. The frequency response of high pass filter is given by, this is the characteristics. This A naught is the midband gain, this is the FL, the A naught by root 2, A naught by root 2, that means this is the 3 dB down. 3 dB down. This is the FL, the lower 3 dB frequency. The midband gain exists at F equal to infinite because this high pass filter passes the high frequency signal. The maximum high frequency signal ideally infinite. That means the high pass filter provides the maximum gain at infinite. High pass filter provides the maximum gain, that means the A naught midband gain at high frequency, that means the F equal to infinite. In case of low pass filter, low pass filter provides the maximum midband gain, that means the maximum gain at low frequency F equal to 0. These two points are very, very important for low pass filter and high pass filter. Okay. In case of ideal characteristics, if I am considering mathematically form, A is 0 for F less than FL, and this is the resultant A naught is F is greater than FL. That means, if I am considering the ideal characteristics, that means FL. After this cutoff frequency, this is the pass band. Before this cutoff frequency, this is the stop band. This is the ideal characteristics, where we consider this is the cutoff frequency, lower 3 dB frequency. This is the lower range. This is why we use the term lower 3 dB frequency. This is because this is the lower range for the pass band. This is the lower frequency range for the pass band. This is the lowest frequency, where we assume the pass band, the cutoff frequency. After that, this high pass filter passes the frequency range. That means the FL is the lowest frequency range for the complete passes range. Okay. And in case of low pass filter, this FH, why we use the terminology is higher 3 dB frequency, because this is the highest frequency range for the pass band. In case of pass band, this is the highest frequency range. This is the highest frequency range for the pass band. That means this terminology is referred as the higher 3D frequency. This FL is the lowest frequency range for this pass band. This FL is referred as lower 3 dB frequency. That's why we used higher 3 dB frequency for low pass filter and lower 3 dB frequency for the high pass filter. These two terminology and concept is very, very important for all of you. Okay. Then we will discuss how this feedback affects the frequency response of this basic amplifier. How this feedback affect the lower 3 dB frequency as well as higher 3 dB frequency as well as concept of bandwidth. How this feedback affect the bandwidth, okay? We will discuss. Consider this A, this basic amplifier, this A is referred as low pass filter. The case number 1, this is the case 1, A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH. This is the basic amplifier, okay? This is the low pass filter, basic amplifier again. A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH. This is the frequency response of low pass filter with feedback factor beta. Okay. The feedback gain is given by is the A upon 1 plus A beta. This is the feedback gain A upon 1 plus A beta, where A is the frequency response of low pass filter, A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH upon 1 plus A naught upon 1 plus J F upon FH into beta. 1 plus j f upon fh is cancel out, a naught upon 1 plus j f upon fh plus a naught beta, okay? And this 1 plus j f upon fh, 1 plus a naught beta, this term 1 plus a naught beta divided by 1 plus a naught beta is divided by all terms, a naught upon 1 plus a naught beta upon 1 plus j f upon fh 1 plus a naught beta. The standard frequency response of low pass filter, the standard frequency response of low pass filter, even in case of complete feedback structure, A up, A naught S upon 1 plus J F upon FH S. The complete frequency response in case of low pass filter, A naught S upon 1 plus J F upon FH S, where A naught S is the midband gain of this feedback structure, this is the feedback amplifier, midband gain is given by A naught upon 1 plus A naught beta. This 1 plus A naught beta is given by D sensitivity. The value of D sensitivity is very, very high. That means midband gain of closed system, midband gain of feedback amplifier decreases by the factor of D. So A naught D is less than A naught. Overall gain of this amplifier is decreases by the factor of D. And FHD is the overall higher 3 dB frequency. Or higher 3 dB frequency with feedback, FHDS, compare with this result, FH into 1 plus A naught beta. That means FH into D. There are two results. Higher 3 dB frequency with feedback increases by the factor of D, and midband gain with feedback decreases by the factor of D. So midband gain decreases by the factor of D, the important result, and higher 3 dB frequency increases by the factor of D. This midband gain decreases by the factor of D, and higher 3 dB frequency increases by the factor of D. The good concept, okay, this is very important for you. If I am considering high pass filter, okay, please note down. In case of high pass filter, if I am considering frequency response of high pass filter, A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F, and the feedback factor is beta, okay. This is the feedback factor is beta, and I am considering A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F. Again, we can use this feedback path gain A upon 1 plus A beta, A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F, okay, upon 1 plus A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F or beta, this is the beta is multiply, 1 minus J FL upon F cancel out, A naught upon 1 minus J FL upon F plus 1 plus A naught beta, 1 plus A naught by beta is divided by this, A naught upon 1 plus A naught beta 1 minus J FL upon F 1 plus A naught beta, okay. You can see here A naught upon 1 plus A naught beta, and the AF in case of high pass filter, okay. AF feedback path gain, high pass filter, AF for high pass filter can be written as is the A naught days upon 1 minus J FL days upon F. This is the A naught days, that means the midband gain with feedback in case of high pass filter. Again, This result is given by a naught upon 1 plus a naught beta. This result is given by a naught by d. Again, we can see here midband gain is always decreases by the factor of d in case of low pass filter as well as high pass filter. Overall, we can say in case of feedback amplifier, midband gain decreases by the factor of d. Okay, a naught dash decreases by factor of d. Even we can consider low pass filter as well as high pass filter. In both cases, we can see a naught dash is equal to a naught by d. We can compare this the lower 3D frequency with feedback FL dash. We can compare this the FL dash from this equation, the FL divide by 1 plus a naught beta. That means lower 3D frequency is decreases by the factor of d. So overall lower 3D frequency, that means the lower 3D frequency with feedback decreases by the factor of d. This is the important result, lower 3D frequency result. This is the midband gain result. This is the higher 3D frequency increases by the factor of d. So result of feedback frequency response of feedback amplifier, there are three results. Midband gain is decreases by the factor of d, a naught upon 1 plus a naught beta. Okay, first result, if the higher 3D frequency with feedback FH increases by the factor of d, that means the 1 plus a naught beta. Lower 3D frequency decreases by the factor of d, FL upon 1 plus a naught beta. There are three important results, the effect of feedback. Okay, I can take one example for explaining you for this higher 3D frequency, lower 3D frequency and midband gain. Okay, if I am considering this the feedback factor beta, if midband gain is 100, suppose the open system midband gain is 100, higher 3D frequency is 10 kilowatts and lower 3D frequency is 10 hertz. Okay, the practical good values, midband gain for this without feedback a naught is 100, higher 3D frequency 10 kilohertz, lower 3D frequency 10 hertz, bandwidth is equal to FH minus FL. 10 kilohertz, that means the 10 raised power 4 minus 10 is approximately 10 raised power 4, that means the 10 kilohertz. That means in open system without feedback, this is the higher 3D frequency. Normally this higher 3D frequency is referred as bandwidth. So sometimes we used low pass filter cutoff frequency is referred as bandwidth. Sometimes this low pass filter cutoff frequency is referred as bandwidth because this FH is greater than FL. The bandwidth is equal to approximately FH without feedback. If I am considering feedback factor beta is 10, if feedback factor beta is 10, then after feedback midband gain is given by a naught upon 1 plus a naught beta. That means if a naught is 100 and 1 plus a naught beta is 10, that means the 1000, we can neglect this 100 cancel out, 1 by 10, 0.1, this is the midband gain decreases by the factor of d. Actually the FH days is equal to FH into 1 plus a naught beta. This a naught beta is 1000, we can neglect 1, the value of FH without feedback is 10 kilohertz without feedback, multiply by a naught beta, because I am neglecting this 1, a naught beta is 1000, a naught beta is 1000, 1000 into 10, that means 10 megahertz. This higher 3D frequency increases, this is the 10 megahertz. Lower 3D frequency with feedback FL dash, FL upon 1 plus a naught beta. Again, this FL is equal to 10 hertz divided by 1 plus a naught beta, we can neglect 1, divided by 1000, that means 1 by 100, 0.01 hertz, 1 by 100. Lower 3D frequency with feedback decreases, higher 3D frequency with feedback increases, midband gain decreases. Or, okay, the result of feedback, the result without feedback. Okay, the bandwidth is 10 kilohertz. The gain bandwidth product without feedback, that means the open system, in case of open system without feedback, gain into bandwidth. Gain is 100, bandwidth is approximately 10 kilohertz, that means 1000 kilohertz, 1 megahertz. Gain bandwidth product without feedback is 1 megahertz, that means the open system gain bandwidth product for this open system is 1 megahertz. This is the 1 megahertz gain bandwidth product. Here I am considering bandwidth days. Bandwidth days is equal to FH days minus FL days. That means FH days is equal to the 10 megahertz and FL days is equal to 0.01 hertz, exactly 10 megahertz. The Without feedback, the bandwidth is given by 10 kilohertz. That means bandwidth days is equal to bandwidth into D. The bandwidth without feedback is the 10 kilohertz. D sensitivity, that means the 1 plus A naught beta, A naught 1 plus A naught beta, approximately 1000. If I am multiplying this, the 1000 with 10, that means 10 megahertz. That means the result of this feedback, we can say here, after feedback, bandwidth increases by the factor of D. You can note down, after feedback, bandwidth increases by factor of D. How? If FH and this FL, this FH increases by the factor of D and FL decreases by the factor of D, overall bandwidth increases by the factor of D. That means we have four results: mid-band gain decreases by the factor of D, higher 3D frequency increases by the factor of D, lower 3D frequency decreases by the factor of D, and the fourth important result, bandwidth approximately increases by the factor of D. The again important result, okay? Here, gain bandwidth product after feedback, gain bandwidth product after feedback, that means the gain into bandwidth. The gain, this is the mid-band gain, is equal to only 0.1, and bandwidth of the feedback is equal to 10 megahertz. 10 megahertz into 0.1, that means the 1 megahertz. Gain bandwidth product without feedback is 1 megahertz. Gain bandwidth product with feedback is 1 megahertz. That means gain bandwidth product will be constant, is very, very important. That means gain bandwidth product for the open system, everywhere gain bandwidth product for open system is same as gain bandwidth product for closed system. That means in case of feedback, gain decreases by the factor of D and bandwidth increases by the factor of D, overall gain bandwidth product will be same. Okay, this is the frequency response. This is the frequency response for basic amplifier. Without feedback, this is the frequency response for basic amplifier. If I am considering feedback, that means gain decreases. That means if I am considering this, the result, the gain decreases. This is the mid-band gain, A naught this. If I am considering this again, this one. This is the A naught, is the 70.7%. We can write here FL days. We can write this is the FH days. That means this FH days is greater than FH. This is the FL days. This FL days is FH days greater than FH. This FL days is less than FH. That means overall bandwidth will increase. Overall bandwidth will increase. If gain decreases, that means bandwidth increases. If gain increases, that means bandwidth will decrease. That means gain and bandwidth inversely proportional. Overall gain bandwidth product will be constant before feedback, after feedback. Okay, this two concept is very, very important. If gain decreases, that means bandwidth increases. If bandwidth decreases, that means the gain increases. Overall gain and bandwidth inversely proportional to each other. Okay, I hope you are enjoying this video, this topic. I am trying to give my best to explaining you. Okay, in next topic we will discuss many things. Okay, thank you.